Shalom, shalom, shalom. Give all praise, honor, and glory to the Most High by Shimon Mashiach Yahushua.
Shimon Mashiach Yahushua.
Right? All power and credit goes to Yahweh by Shimon Mashiach Yahushua forever and ever. Amen. So we're going to continue to teach this word in the midst of a damn tornado out here that the Most High has brought. But the forces of nature are controlled by the Most High. So everything he does on the earth is to show his power. Everything the Most High does on the earth, that them tornadoes that's coming this week from the Midwest to the East, that's to show the power of the Most High. Right? What's your name again? Daniel? Right? Daniel bowing down to the men of the Lord, that's to show the power of the Most High.
That's right.
Us being out here open, live, and direct as Hebrew Israelites, showing that we are the true teachers of the Most High, that's of the power of the Most High.
That's right.
So everything goes to the power of the Heavenly Father and His Son, whom the world ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, HaMashiach Yahusha. Right, so we're going to teach His word, whether you like it, understand it, accept it, believe it or not. And there's a lot of prophecy going on. There's a lot of prophecy going on where the Most High is showing you He's about to end this place. The Lord is showing you He's about to end America, end the rulership of the white man, end the rulership of the Illuminati, the power structure, and bring His chosen people back to the knowledge of who we are.
Right,
and back to rulership on this earth. And if you don't believe it, guess what? So damn what?
Right.
We don't care. If you don't believe it, that's too bad.
Right.
Up here is no holds barred. We're going to tell you like it is.
Right.
We're going to tell you, thus saith the Lord, or nothing at all. Now you got to partner with that, take it up with the Heavenly Father. Because we're teaching you, thus saith the Lord. But before we get into these prophecies, give me Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5. Give me the book of Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5. And we're going to get into all this prophecy that the Most High is making have on the earth, all over the place. Now hold what you got. He'll be primary, you'll be backup. Now give me Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5. Read that, brother.
Deuteronomy 4 and 5.
Okay.
Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments.
The Lord said He have taught us statutes and judgments. The Lord taught us the laws and commandments of this Bible and the punishments for breaking those laws, which are the judgments. God,
even as the Lord, my power, commanded me.
See that? Moses said, just as He commanded us. So what is our first duty coming out here? Our first duty is to teach the so-called Black, Hispanic, Native American, and Seminole Indian that you are the chosen people of the Lord.
Right.
And that America is about to be destroyed in World War III.
Right.
Even Barack Obama, even Obama said we're keeping some extra arrows in our quiver because of what's going on between Russia and the Ukraine.
Right.
So the Bible speaks about the missiles, and the Bible calls the missiles arrows. So why did Obama say that? That's cryptic language from the Illuminati.
You know what?
He said we're keeping some extra arrows in our quiver. Why is Obama saying that? You know what he's saying? He's saying, in other words, we're keeping the nuclear missiles ready. Because World War III is on the brink, but we're going to get into that in a minute. Read what you got, brother. Deuteronomy 4 and 5 again from the top. Read.
Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments.
The Lord said He taught Israel statutes and judgments. Come on.
Even as the Lord, my power, commanded me.
Just like the Lord commanded us. The Lord commanded, He gave us a strict commandment to come out here, and He said the number one thing is to tell the Israelites who they are.
That's right.
The number one thing is to bring the Israelites back to the knowledge of the Bible. The number one thing is to tell them to repent and keep the commandments and get ready for the kingdom of heaven.
Right.
Right, go ahead.
That ye should do so in the land whither ye go to possess it.
The Lord said we shall do them laws in the land whither we go to possess it. And the land that we're going to possess is the land of Israel, just like the ancient time. The Bible says there's nothing new under the sun. We were the children of Israel back then, and we're still the children of Israel today.
Right.
The land of Israel was given to us back then, is going to be given back to us today.
Right.
Keep therefore and do them.
God said, keep the commandments and do them. Read on.
For this is your wisdom.
This is our wisdom, our common sense. Come on.
And your understanding.
And our understanding, our comprehension. God.
In the sight of the nations.
The Lord said, this is our wisdom and understanding in the sight of all the nations. When we come back to these laws, statutes, and commandments, that's the solution.
That's
Right. You so-called Negroes, you're looking for a solution right. Everywhere else.
Right.
Now you're saying, well, who's running in the 2016 election? Is it going to be Jeb Bush against Hillary Clinton?
Right.
And either way you're going with Satan.
Bam.
Either way you're going, if you got a Bush or a Clinton in the White House, first of all, they're one and the same because they're all related.
Right.
And you've had the Bush and the Clinton dynasty have ran the White House since the 80s.
Right.
Right.
There's been a Bush or a Clinton in the White House since the Ronald Reagan administration.
Right.
Because you had a senior Bush as vice president.
Right.
Right. Then you had senior Bush become president. Then you had Slick Willie, Bill Clinton.
Right.
He did two terms.
Right.
Right. Then you had Baby Bush. He did two terms.
Right.
Then you threw everybody a curveball and you brought Barack Obama in there,
right.
But you had Hillary right up there with him. Secretary of State or whatever the hell her flattering title was.
Right.
So you had a Bush or a Clinton in the White House since the Reagan administration. So it don't matter, man. Either way, they both Satan.
Right.
They two fleas on the same damn dog.
Right. Right.
They both Satan, and what's going to happen, either one you elect, more than likely is going to bring us into that third world's war.
Ready.
Right.
Right, so that's what Obama said, and he's one of them also.
Right.
Obama said, we keeping some extra arrows in our quiver. Them arrows are them nuclear bombs, man. That's cryptic language from the Illuminati.
Right.
The damn Rothschilds probably smoked some damn crack and said, hey, tell Obama in his speech tomorrow to talk about arrows in the quiver.
Right.
They probably was high as hell in a mountain in damn London somewhere.
Right. Right, right.
And they said, look, they made a phone call and said, tell Obama to talk about arrows in the quiver in his next speech tomorrow.
Right.
That's how them psychos do, man.
Right.
They play games. They play like a chess game with the world, man.
Right.
That's how they do. It's all fun and games to them because they're at the top and the Most High got them in that Pharaoh-type pride. They're in that Pharaoh-type pride when the Lord is lifting them up to show his power so he can bring them down.
Right.
Right, so we know.
Keep therefore and do this.
The Lord said, keep the commandments and do them. Read on.
For this is your wisdom.
This is our wisdom. Come on.
And your understanding.
And our understanding, God.
In the sight of the nations.
In the sight of all the nations. You know how you so-called blacks, Latinos, Native Americans, and Seminole Indians show that you're the people of God? By keeping God's laws. Yeah, you so-called Latinos too, man. Y'all God's people also.
Right.
And y'all got to repent and keep the laws of the Bible. And the Moreno is your brother. Regardless of what anybody say, man. No, we're not all brothers. The Morenos, Hispanics, and the Native Americans are all brothers.
That's right.
But the hell with the white man. You're right. That's right. Right? El Blanco. El Blanco Diablo.
That's right.
Jesucristo Moreno.
El Blanco. Los Blancos son
diablos. He's the red devil. Right there. There he is right there.
There you go. Red hell. Right. Tall with it. Tall devil.
Look like the damn man on a hot sauce bottle. Right, big tall red devil for you right there. The Most High let his ass come over here to be a model. All right, brothers, repent, man. Repent, and the Moreno is your brother.
That's right.
We are here.
Which shall hear all these statutes.
The Lord said you shall hear all these statutes and laws that's been given to you, like the law against being a homosexual.
Right.
You better stop that faggot spirit that's running rampant in America.
Right.
The Lord made man to be with woman and woman to be with man.
That's right.
Right? No lesbianism, no homosexuality in the sight of the Lord. That's a sin and an abomination. Right, go ahead.
And say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people.
The Lord says, surely the nation's going to look at you and say, this is a great and wise and understanding people, man. So that's what we out here for. Our main thing is to teach the laws, statutes, and commandments to the so-called black, Hispanic, Native American, and Seminole Indian of Indian and Negro descent. Nobody else is the Lord's people, man. Only the people that we just mentioned of the 12 tribes of the lost nation of Israel, but now we're found. We're found. You know why we're found? Because the Bible is here. The truth is here. Yahushua said the gospel shall be preached in all the world, and then shall it end come.
That's right.
So we here, man. We out. We're live and direct. We're live and direct with the word of the Most High. And you're not going to stop it either. no matter what kind of schisms you try, no matter how many COINTELPRO, CIA, operatives, Homeland Security you try to infiltrate our different organizations with, it's not gonna work. We laughing at you because you can do nothing against the truth but for the truth.
That's right.
Well, what nation is there so great?
The Lord said, what nation is there so great? You know what?
Who hath the Most High so nigh unto them?
Who hath the Lord so nigh unto them? What nation is so great that got the Most High near unto them? No nation on the earth, man. You so-called blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, and Seminole Indians, you are the greatest people walking the planet earth.
Right.
But you don't want to receive that. You don't want to receive that. Only time you want to hear something is when it's defending the enemy. Like the young black man up here earlier, he damn near going to convulsions to defend the damn white man.
Right.
The man damn near going to a damn epileptic fit.
Right.
He would think he got epilepsy or something, trying to swallow his tongue.
Right.
Because he want to defend the so-called white man.
Right.
That's a shame that 2014, majority of you so-called Negroes and Hispanics still can't learn to love each other. That's why the guy, the president from the LA Clippers.
Oh yeah.
He told his black girlfriend, don't bring no blacks around me.
That's right.
He said, I don't care if it's Magic Johnson. Don't bring no blacks around me. Right. I ain't never liked no blacks around me.
Don't bring them to my game.
Then what the hell you doing with a black woman?
Right.
Don't bring no blacks around me. I don't like no blacks. But I like some nigga juice every once in a while.
Right.
Like Billy Bob Thornton's father said in that movie Monsters Ball.
Right.
He said, I don't like niggers, but I sure like some nigga juice. In other words, I like your black woman every once in a while.
Right.
So that's why we gotta stand up and be men and defend this gospel, this truth, and our nation. Because a white man let you know in 2014 he still don't want no niggas around him.
Right.
And here the man is the president of a damn NBA team.
Really now.
And he's telling you that.
Right.
And isn't that something we run out here in Los Angeles when this incident happens? Hell. Right out here. We should go to the Staples Center?
Hell camp.
And have a damn camp there. We should go to the damn Staples Center and have a damn camp at the Staples Center on game night.
Right.
Thank God, brother. Read what you got.
Ezra 9:12. Now therefore, give not your daughters unto their sons.
That's what the Lord said, don't give our daughters unto their sons.
Right.
Because a white man will have his way with your woman, but he hates you as a nation.
Right.
Come on.
Right.
Neither take their daughters unto your
sons. Neither take your daughters unto their sons. But O.J. Simpson should have showed you that.
Right.
Then O.J. should have showed you that. O.J. had a skanky, damn cokehead, whorish white woman.
There you go.
And he tried to make her into the good old golden strawberry blonde white girl that he wanted her to be.
Right.
But it didn't work. It didn't work. Because what, she revert back to that old cave damn woman that she always been.
That's right.
Sniffing coke, being a whore, lying to OJ in his face.
Right.
OJ said, damn it, I'm the juice, you can't lie to me.
Don't matter.
You can't lie to the juice.
Don't matter.
That white woman said, look, I was here, there, and everywhere, but she was out sniffing coke, turning tricks and doing that whatever the hell else she wanted to do.
Chop her head off.
Right, that's what she was doing. So you should have seen that, man. Michael Strahan, that big simple Negro. Kelly and Michael, my big King Kong effect Negro.
Right.
King Kong Fay Wray Negro. The big oversized black man with the little white woman.
Right.
The King Kong effect. And even Michael Strahan, his white woman turned out to be a damn dog that took him, tried to take him for all his damn money. That's how this society is. Every time you black men get with the white woman and you get in a position, she's sure that she's the devil that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
But Don Cornelius. Right? Love, peace, and soul. What happened? This damn white woman, after 2 years of them being divorced, still took this man's money.
That's right.
This man was dead. Committed suicide, or they suicided him. This man was dead and gone, and they said she still have the right to his $15 million that he had left. His two young Jake sons, they don't get nothing. His two young black sons, they don't get nothing. But this damn skank white woman, she gets his $15 million. Michael Jackson's children. You can tell Michael Jackson's children, they're a bunch of little demons. Because the girl, she cursed out the grandmother, cursed out Janet.
Right.
Janet got that old Negro woman in her that smacked the hell out of that little white girl.
That's right. That's right.
Janet said, now, wait a minute, damn it. I'm still a Negro woman. Who you think you're talking to, little white girl? Bam! And smacked the hell out of her. Then she went to go to a rock concert, and the mother told her no, and she going to try to commit suicide.
Right, crazy.
Because they Esau, man. They ain't nowhere near no damn Michael Jackson's children.
Nah, white folks.
They the devil. Right. But what happened? Michael Jackson died, and them two little demons get his money.
Right.
It's the same thing. You marry or bear children or try to get with the white man, you're going to get the same results.
Right.
Because they the devil then, they the devil now, and when you check in the future, they'll be the devil.
They're
going to
be the devil.
That's a good, brother. Nor seek their peace or their wealth. The Lord said, nor seek their peace nor their wealth. Go ahead.
That's right.
Nor seek their peace nor their wealth forever. The Lord said, nor seek their peace or their wealth forever. You can't seek their peace or their wealth.
That's right.
Every time you try to get with them, marry them, do business with them. Yeah, I deal with white people, man, because they better. Yeah, a lot of times that is true. But in the long run, they're going to show their true colors. You know what? That ye may be strong and eat the good things of the land. The Lord said that you may be strong. You keep your seed and your nation strong by not being with the white man and the other nation.
That's right.
Right. That's
right.
How you build yourself up. So you got to understand, the Lord told us to stay away. That's why the guy from the LA Clippers, what's his name? The president of the LA Clippers, what's his name? Donald Sterling. He's a so-called Jew boy. He said, don't bring no blacks around me. I don't like blacks. I ain't never liked blacks.
Right.
He said, I hate them. He said, I hate
them.
He said, listen, I don't even care if it's Magic Johnson.
That's right.
Wow. And listen, Magic is a Negro with money.
Right. I ain't afraid.
Magic is an uppity Negro.
All of them white boys like Magic.
Yeah, all of them little white boys like Magic.
Right.
He's the acceptable Negro by America. But he said, I don't even care if it's Magic Johnson. Don't bring him around me.
Right.
He said, because I don't like blacks. I ain't never liked blacks. I hate blacks. There you go, in 2014. Now, for all you Negroes that like the LA Clippers,
there go
your president of the LA Clippers. That's how they feel about you in 2014. I want that to marinate, man.
Right.
I want that to sink in and marinate, because you Negroes always forgetting.
Always.
Give me Ecclesiastes 12 and 10 real quick.
Always.
You always forgetting, man.
Right.
Give me Proverbs 28 and 26. You always forgetting, and what happened? Just like the Native American, the white man pat you on the back and stab you in the stomach.
Right.
That's right.
Right.
Just like he did to the so-called Native American Indian. Give me the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 10. Brother, read that.
Ecclesiastes 12, verse 10.
Come on.
Never trust thine enemy.
The Bible says never trust your enemy, man. It don't shock us. The men of the Lord, the scriptures say in 2 Peter 1:19, we have a more sure word of prophecy. So we already know this stuff going to happen, man.
That's right.
We be sitting back looking, yo, who you think the next racial incident going to be with? Right, come on.
But like as iron rusted.
The Lord said, just like iron is sure to rust, come on.
So is his wickedness.
His wickedness gonna come out, man. His hatred gonna come out. Read on.
Though he humble himself.
Go ahead, humble himself. Go ahead.
And go crouching.
And go crouching. Just like they said, when you watch the movie 42, the Jackie Robinson story. And the white man said, look, the white man said, I don't care about white or black. I care about green and winning games. It's not that he loved you Negroes. You Negroes got happy.
Right.
We're the first black man in the baseball league.
Yeah.
I was gonna say NFL, that's football. Right? MLB, Major League Baseball. Right. First black man. You see the white man in that movie, I believe it was Harrison Ford that played the part. And he said, I don't care if he's a black man. I just wanna win baseball games.
Right.
And when you win games, it makes us money.
Right.
You niggas thought it was a milestone.
Right.
Niggas done crushed over the threshold. Y'all was good. Y'all was good keeping y'all Negro League.
Right. Good.
Y'all could have kept the money around good, amongst good. Yourselves.
Right.
And dominated the white man still.
Right.
And still showed that you was better at the game than him. You thought it was a milestone. But he said no. It's not about he went and told Jackie Robinson everything he wanted to hear, and I'm going to pay you all this money. Don't he go humble himself and go crouching, God.
Yet take good heed and beware of him.
Yet take good heed and beware of him. Look at Mr. Sterling from the LA Clippers. He got Negroes on the basketball team, plenty of them. But he said, look, don't he go humbling and crouching? Don't he have that modern day slave auction?
Right.
What they call it, the NBA draft?
Yeah, the draft.
$100 million for 7 years. They're going easy street. And all you players, you end up blowing your damn money and being broke as hell when you retire anyway.
Right, nothing.
Gotta be like Shaq, man, on a damn soda can.
Right.
With a big smile on your damn face.
Oh, that money, man.
Right, they're doing all kinds of stupid parts in movies to make a buck.
Right.
Man, go ahead.
And thou shalt be unto him as if thou hast wiped a looking glass.
The Lord said, you're going to be unto him like you wiped the looking glass, God.
And thou shalt know that his rust has not been altogether wiped away.
You're going to know that his rust, his wickedness, his evil, his racism, his hatred. And we're not really boo-hoo crying about the white man being a racist.
Right.
We're just bringing it out. We're just trying to let you Negroes know, wake the hell up. And see past the facade. Look at the real. Right. We're not boo-hooing, oh, white man, love me, no.
Right.
Just like when Imus in the morning, that cat Imus, he said that the girls from the Syracuse basketball team, yeah. There was a bunch of nappy-headed hoes.
Right.
We didn't get all sad at because Imus said that. We said, look, this how this devil is.
That's how he is.
Then all them black women, they went and got their hair done. They went and got their hair done and did interviews.
Right.
And they said, wait, Mr. Imus. We got nice hair. Right. You know why? Because they was hurt. Their spirit was hurt that the white man said that to them.
Right, they were hurt, all right.
That's what it was. Their spirit was hurt. Thank you, brother. Their spirit was hurt and in pain that master said that to them. Right. So they said, no, let us go get our hair did. Let's go get our hair done and show we got nice hair. No. He said, them some nappy-headed hoes.
Right.
And listen, all we trying to show you is this how this man feels about you. Repent and come back to the Lord of the Bible.
Be separate
from them and let's love one another and come amongst each other.
Come.
Because right. I made you something. It's deeper than this white man.
Way deep.
That ain't nothing, man, but we got to drill through him to get to y'all.
Right.
At the end of the day, when we can get our people away from this devil, excuse me, when we can get them away from this devil, then we can come together and do what we need to do. But it's a breaking process. Just like the so-called white man broke you during slavery, now we gotta unbreak you and break you and bring you back to the Most High. Uh-huh. Right, so we done.
Set him not by thee, lest when he hath overthrown thee.
The Lord said, don't set him by you, lest when he overthrow you, God.
He stand up in thy place.
He stand up in your place, man. That's what Esau do. Didn't Esau do that to the Native American Indians? He raped, he robbed, he murdered, he slaughtered. And he took them down. All kinds of spirits out here, but anyway. Go ahead.
Wicked kind.
Neither let him sit at thy right hand.
The Lord said, don't let him sit at your right hand. In other words, don't make no agreements with this so-called white man. Well, you know you got to agree with them at work. Right. At school and business, don't be simple.
Right.
In other words, don't make a covenant with this man like you going to build with him and be a nation with him.
Right.
You deal with him as far as he deal with you, and you deal with your internal dealings amongst your people. Right, go ahead.
Lest he seek to take thy seat.
Lest what?
He seek to take thy seat.
And that's the so-called white man for you. Now that's why they breaking their neck to try to get a white boy that's king of rap.
Right.
Look at for 2013 they gave all them Grammys to that white boy that made the song about faggots.
Yeah.
Like you said, man, I can't even keep up with these rappers no more,
me
man.
Neither,
what's his name? Macklemore? Yeah, Macklemore. Some white boy rapping about homosexuality is okay, and they gave him rap album of the year, rap song of the year, or whatever the hell. They had the brother from out here, the brother from Compton, Kendrick Lamar. They had that brother on. They said, well, that brother deserves all them awards because he's a better rapper. And they said, no, they gave it to the white boy. They said, this is the first time that there has not been a black artist on a Billboard Top 100. One of these months or weeks or whatever, it was the first time in a long time, in half long they've been calculating, that is, it has not been a so-called Negro artist on the Billboard Top 100. What is that telling you? They said, look, we don't lead you niggas no more.
That's right.
Somebody put up a post on our Facebook about that. They said, listen, attention all you black artists. Thank you for all your years of service and giving your talent over to the white artists. We will no longer be needing your services. Slowly but surely, we're going to get rid of y'all out of the music industry. Yes, man. I kid you not. Somebody put that up on Facebook. I should have downloaded it and made a copy of it. One of them brothers, they put up an article from a anonymous source in the music industry. Probably once again, Rothschild smoking his crack.
Right.
And said, listen, we going to tell the nigga artists how we really feel about him.
Right.
We done used y'all. So there's racism all over, and all these other great inventors.
Right.
All these brothers that some of them you never even heard of, man. You don't even know the things that they invented.
Right.
They invented, the white man said, hey, buddy, what's that you made there? Hey, man, that's great, man. Do you know I can sell this thing? There he is.
Yeah.
There he is, he just smiled, right? Might have stole something from a nigga recently.
That's right.
Right, what you got? Yeah. Right, he was nodding his head, right?
Right.
And them look like some damn incognito Edomites. Probably some damn billionaires.
Right.
Some damn, took a Negro's invention somewhere,
right,
and then made $1 billion off of it. But the Lord said, don't set him by you, because when you set him by you, he gonna seek to take your seat. Right, come on.
And thou at the last, remember my word.
See that? The Lord said at the last, you gonna remember his words, come on.
And be pricked therewith.
And you gonna be pricked therewith. You know what that means? You're going to be victim to the old cliche, I told you so. You're going to say, damn. And somebody going to come look at you and say, oh, you're going to say, oh, don't even say it. I told you so.
Right.
Your spirit going to be cut, man.
That's right.
And that's what's going to happen to a lot of our people in the last days.
Right.
Hold on, read what you got, brother.
Isaiah 52 and verse 3, thus saith the Most High. You have sold yourselves for naught.
Yeah, our people have sold themselves for naught, man. The majority of you so-called blacks and Hispanics, you sell out for nothing.
Nothing.
You know what? And you shall be redeemed. You're going to be redeemed. You're going to be brought back to the Most High. Come on.
Without money.
Without money, man. The Lord going to redeem you back to him without money. All the selling out that you've done to America is going to profit you nothing.
Right.
You're going to end up, after the white man finished chewing you up, he's going to spit you right out.
All day.
That's right.
You ain't going to have a damn thing when the smoke clears.